Hi, my name is Greg Dale. I'm a parent, I'm a speaker at TEDx this year, and this is my speaker interview. Why did you decide to speak at the TEDx event? Who inspired and encouraged you to? Nobody encouraged me. I saw it last year, I didn't watch all of it, but I thought it was really interesting. And I'm kind of challenging myself for all these kinds of things to be able to stand up in front of people. I do public speaking, but it's great to do it in all kinds of different arenas. So once I found out that Seisen was doing TEDx, I thought it would be a great idea. I've also never done like a TED type speaking process, so I thought it would be a lot of fun to be able to move around and do it in that arena. What are you most excited about in your TEDx? I'm an actor director, and I work with a lot of people, Japanese mostly. And for me, the thing that really excites me the most is to see everybody progress. There are a lot of things that I've learned in life, and to be able to share that with people and help them in the acting field to be better actors is something that really makes me feel great. And in terms of public speaking, I think that it's incredibly important for all of you in your lives. And if I can help anybody just get over that hump of nervousness and shyness, I think that would be great. How do you plan on educating others, the audience, about your topic? Hopefully by being funny. I don't know, I almost got a laugh. Public speaking is, I think the more personal you can be, the more relaxed you can be, the more relaxed the audience can be. And so, I don't know, I think I have so many things to say, I can't actually pack it into 7 minutes of TEDx, but I've narrowed it down to things that I think are really important, and hopefully it'll be important for the people listening too. This is a tiny question. Why have you chosen your topic? Okay. My kids, my daughter is here, and she used to go to Nishimachi. My son is still at Nishimachi. And the amazing thing about Nishimachi is that the kids are incredibly bold. At 6, 7 years old, they'll come to you, they'll talk to you, they'll show you their favorite toy. It's really amazing. That keeps going in a very casual atmosphere. But as soon as they get up, during assembly or for presentation for the parents or whatever, they all pull back. They all get tiny and clam up. And this is something that was really interesting to me because I was also very shy when I was a kid. And I used acting as a way of breaking out of my shell and being able to use all different types, all different parts of me that normally I wouldn't be able to use. So, at some point I realized this was something that really could help other people. And I started doing public speaking with CEOs, executives of really big Japanese corporations, helping them to be more personable and friendly and really connect with their audience. And then I realized that this is something that's going to be incredibly important for kids too. You guys are going to be doing interviews for the rest of your lives. And for so many of us, actually they say that the thing that we fear the most is death. And the thing we fear second most is public speaking. So, for so many people, it's a hump that they just can't get over, or they hate it so much that it's like pulling teeth every time they get up in front of people. And this is going to go on for the rest of your lives. I mean, whether it's meeting somebody at a party, or it's a job interview, or, you know, a speech, you have to get up in front of people much, much more than I ever did. And I think that this is something that, if I can make it easier, and not just easier, if I can make it fun, if I can make it something that you really excel at, then that's all I can wish for. What would you consider your strengths and weaknesses? You have to ask my kids. No, actually, I think like everybody, your strength, your main strength, is also your main weakness. So I'm very easygoing. I listen a lot more than speak. You wouldn't know it now, but and so I can also be lazy because I'm easygoing. There are lots of opportunities that kind of come by and I just, you know, I don't jump on them like many people do. And in terms of listening, there are just some times that I don't express my opinion because I don't want to hurt people. So, you know, strengths and weaknesses are pretty much the same, well, the opposite side of the same coin. I'm Greg Dale, and this was my speaker interview.